energy which gives us sensation of hearing. Very good. So the form of energy which gives us sensation of hearingness will be called sound. And about that sound actually we are going to learn. But before going to learn about sound, what are the parameters of it, how it will travel, and in which material, how it travels, what will be the equation for velocity of sound, on what factors velocity of sound will depend upon. So before going to learn about all those things, today we are going to learn first about wave motion. And after learning about wave motion, you are going to learn about different types of waves, what are the differences between them, and what are the characteristics of those waves. And when you learn about it, you'll get some idea related to the sound, and later we'll discuss about purely related to sound only. So once again, tell me Arnav, what is the sound? Can you hear me, Arnav?
Yes, you are there now? I'm able to hear you.
Okay, tell me, what do you mean by sound?
The sound is a form of energy.
Very good. Sound is a form of...
That makes us able to hear things.
Right. Sound is a form of energy which gives us sensation of hearingness. Isn't it? Sensation of hearingness. Okay. Can you say about light? What is a light? What is a light, Arnav?
Sir, light is also a form of an energy.
Right. Light is also a form of energy. Then what is the difference between sound and this light?
Sir, they both travel in different mediums.
So here I said sound energy means the form of energy which gives us sensation of hearingness will be called sound. But I am asking you about light. What is a light? It is also a form of energy which gives us sensation of what? Seeingness. So sensation of seeingness will be created by one kind of an energy, and that energy will be called what? Light actually. And whatever energy forms which are there, which will be available in nature, generally gives some sort of sense for our human body. All will not give, few energies will give some sort of sense for our human body, like sound energy, light energy. Apart from sound and light energy, you can say about heat energy also. Now maybe you know that heat is also a form of energy which gives us sensation of hotness or coldness. So like this, many forms of energies are there in the nature which can give some sort of sense for our human body. Either sensation of hearingness or sensation of seeingness or hotness or coldness. And among it, sound will be what? Sensation of hearingness. So the form of energy which gives a sensation of hearingness will be called sound. Okay. Now sound is a form of energy. You only said light is also energy, heat is also energy, like that. Now how these energies will be transported from one point to another point? Suppose if a vibration is created here, some vibrations are created. When vibrations are created, what will be produced? Generally, what will be produced when vibrations are there? Arnav?
The vibration.
Vibration produces what? Generally?
Disturbance.
Okay. Let me ask you in other way. Then you can give the answer. How sound produces? How sound produces?
Sir, when there is a vibration in a medium.
Very good. When vibrations are there in an object, then definitely what will be created? Sound will be created. Suppose when we are speaking, What will vibrate? Vocal cords, whatever are there in our human body will vibrate. Because of that, you are getting the sound energy. So that means vibrations will create energy, whether it may be sound energy, light energy, heat energy, whatever it may be. Generally, vibrations will be there. But particularly for sound energy, vibrations will be created. And when vibrations are created, suppose vibrations are created in our body and those vibrations will produce sound energy, and this sound energy will travel from one point to another point or not? Whether sound energy travels from one point to another point or not? And how it travels from one point to another point? Sound travels from one point to the another point in the form of a wave. And today's session particularly is related to the wave only. What is a wave? What do you mean by wave motion? How to understand about it? How many types of waves will be there? And what are the differences between them? So those things we are going to learn. So first try to understand, because of the vibrations in any medium, sound will be created, and this sound in a medium will travel in the form of a wave. Then what is a wave? So first we have to understand about wave. Can anybody say what is a wave? What is a wave? Arnav and Sahas. Arnav, tell me. What is a wave?
Sir, a disturbance created in a medium.
Very good. Disturbance created in a medium. Disturbance created in a medium is known as wave. Is it right answer? It is somewhat nearest answer for the wave. Disturbance created in a medium. Okay. When disturbance is created, tell me what happens. When disturbance is created, what happens?
The particles of the medium vibrate to and fro about their mean position.
Okay. Particles of the medium will vibrate to and fro. In another way, you say disturbance created in a medium. Disturbance means you are saying that particles will vibrate to and fro, maybe. But I am asking, when disturbance is created in a medium, what will happen? Disturbance means, let us understand like this. Now, let us take some water is there and I dropped one stone into it. Tell me what happens when I drop a stone into it.
Sir, ripples created.
Very good. Ripples will be created. Apart from ripples, you have to say like this. A disturbance will be created here. Disturbance created means whatever the energy which is there for this particular stone, as it is coming with some velocity, it will have some kinetic energy. And that kinetic energy, whatever will be there, will be given to the particles which are of water. So it is touching the water molecule, no? Whenever it is touching the water molecule here, whatever the kinetic energy is there for this stone, that will be given to this particular water molecule here. And water molecule, after getting that energy, what it will do is, it will transport that energy from one particle to the another particle. And by transferring energy from one particle to the another particle, what happens is energy will be transported from one point to the another point without the movement of the particles of the medium. And this type of a movement only will be called wave motion. So actually disturbance is created. Disturbance is created means energy will be created. And that energy will be carried from one point to the another point actually. And that is only called wave and how it moves from one point to another point, that will be known as wave motion. So first you have to understand about wave. What is a wave? Disturbance created, already you said. But when disturbance is created, what will happen? That you have to say. So when disturbance is created, energy will be created, and that energy will be transported from one point to another point. So that's why wave can be defined in a particular manner like this. The transportation agent. The transportation agent of an energy. Agent of an energy is known as wave. The transportation agent. That means energy will be carried from one point to another point in the form of wave. So that means wave is carrying energy from one point to another point. So if you say this, this will be the correct meaning for a wave. So again, let me say, the transportation agent of an energy from one point to the another point will be known as what? Wave, actually. And how wave will move? Wave will move from one particle to the another particle. That means energy will be carried from one particle to the another particle without the movement of the particles. And this particular transfer of energy only will be called wave motion. And you can understand wave motion like this. Suppose here, when I drop stone here, energy is produced here, and with the energy, whatever the water molecule is there, where the stone is touching, so it gains energy. And when it gains energy, generally you know that every atom in any substance will execute simple harmonic motion. Which motion will be there for every atom in any substance? Simple harmonic motion will be there. Simple harmonic motion is nothing but one type of a vibratory motion. So vibratory motion means moving to and fro from a mean position. So that means this particle, whatever is there, water particle, whatever is there here, this particle generally will vibrate to and fro like this. Now before touching the stone, let us say water molecule is moving up to this distance from here to here, from mean position, this mean position. And when stone comes and touches here and imparts energy to this particular atom, then what happens is it increases its vibration. That means amplitude of this particular vibrations will increase. And when vibrations are increased, then what happens is this atom will collide with the nearest atom, which is beside of it. And when it is colliding with the nearest atom, beside atom, then what happens is whatever the energy is there for this particular atom will be transmitted to say next particle. And when this particular particle gets energy, now what happens is it increases its amplitude. When it increases its amplitude, what happens? It collides with the next particle and energy will be transmitted when it is colliding with the next particle. So energy transported here. And again, this particular particle will increase its amplitude as it is gaining the energy. Then again, what happens? This atom will collide with the next atom. Now when collision is taking place, now what will happen again? Energy will be transported from this particular atom to this particular atom. So like that, continuously what happens is, because of the collisions of an atom, when it is increasing its amplitude, energy will be transported from one point to another point. But particles are not moving. Particles will move from its mean position only. Maybe amplitude will increase, but it will not move from one point to the another point. But what will move? Energy will move from one point to the another point, and this type of transmission of energy from one molecule to the another molecule, or one particle to the another particle, will be known as wave motion. And remember, in general, in a wave motion, energy only will be carried from one point to the another point without the movement of particles of the medium. So this is what you have to understand, and about this particular wave motion we are going to discuss now. So maybe you understood what is a wave, how energy will be transmitted from one point to another point. So let me ask you a few questions again, and thereby we'll start our session. Now tell me, what is a wave? Anyone? What is a wave? Arnav? What is a wave?
Sir, I have already told.
Again, I changed it, no? Disturbance created in a medium is not appropriate answer. Apart from that, you can give one more answer, and that answer you have to say whatever I said now.
Disturbance created in a medium due to which energy is transferred.
Right. Disturbance created in a medium will be called as wave. But particular meaning you have to give like this. The transportation agent of an energy will be called wave. That means whenever you say about any wave, energy will be carried from one point to the another point. That's why your answer must be this one. The transportation agent of an energy from one point to the another point will be known as wave. And what do you mean by wave motion? If energy is carried from one point to the another point without the movement of the particles of the medium, then that will be known as what? Wave motion actually. So you have to understand two points here. One is about wave and another is about wave motion. So briefly again, Sahas, tell me, what is a wave? Sahas.
Yes, sir.
Tell me, what is a wave?
Yes, sir. The wave, the transportation agent of an energy is a wave.
Very good. The transportation agent of an energy will be known as what? Wave. And what do you mean by wave motion, Arnav? Wave motion. What you understood related to wave motion? Which will be carried from one point to another point? Tell me, Arnav.
The motion of the wave throughout the medium in which the particles are not transferred.
Okay. Particles are not moving, but what is moving? Your answer is somewhat right. Particles are not moving from one point to the another point. But what is moving?
The wave, the energy.
Wave, you have to say energy. If an energy is transported from one point to another point without the movement of the particles of the medium, then that type of a motion only called what? Wave motion. So this is what you have to understand. And how many types of waves will be there? How to understand?